All right, so once Microsoft Word opens, it's gonna look like this. This is our standard view, but we're gonna not stay in this view for today. I'm gonna show you how, and I'm gonna show you why. Okay, so first step is to ensure that our screen looks like this. Then, well, let me readjust this window, slide it over here. We're gonna move all the way up to the top here where it says View. And as you can see right now, we're in the print layout view. What we want to do is switch to notebook layout view. But when we do that, the screen should transform and look like this. You may get a pop-up window that explains to you that you're trying to convert the document if you type something in advance. But if not, oh yeah, when you see that dialog box, you can just click on Create New. And let's look at what we've got over here. So we've got several options here, but you'll notice that it looks like a traditional notebook, and there's a reason for that. These tabs over here on the side, you see where it says section 1, section 2, section 3. These are different tabs. Now, why am I explaining this? Essentially, what you can do is have an entire semester contained within one document. It's a great way to stay organized, but it's also a great way to segment chapters, for example. We'll get into the purpose of that a little bit later, but let's look at the functionality of these tabs to begin, okay? So you'll notice that every time I click on a particular tab, the color corresponds with the tab, which means that now we're in section 2 and now we're in section 3. If you want to add a new section, you can just click right here on the plus sign, and then a new section will pop up. Now I know what you're thinking. Hey Chris, how come section 4 is the same color as section 3? Take it easy. We can fix that right now. All you got to do is right-click on the tab that you wish to change the color, highlight section color, and let's change it to red since we don't see that one yet. Okay? You'll also notice that the section tab corresponds with the title tab up here. Speaking of the title tab, let's label this something. So if we move to the top of our notebook here and click on this section just once, you can type in the purpose of the lecture or whatever it is you're wanting to work with or take notes on. And we're going to call this audio recording. You might be asking, why on earth is he calling it that? Well, I'll explain everything in a moment. Now, notice that the title up here does not correspond with the section tab, and you can change that as you see fit. Now, normally, as I explained, I break these up into 13 weeks so that I have 1 week for each class that I have throughout a particular term. So I normally label these week 01 so I can remember in week 1 we covered an audio recording tutorial. Well, it's very simple to type notes. All you need to do is type, and the text will appear. If you want to create a new tab, you simply press the Enter key. So I'm going to press Enter now, and there's a new tab. All right, this is a great way to keep your notes organized, but you'll notice that everything is based on tabs. Every time you highlight a section, you'll see the different note as a sort of a hidden bullet point. Okay, so in week 1, you can see that the first note was teaching us how to type and create a, sorry, not a new tab. I'm going to change that word to bullet point. Aha. Okay, so now here comes the fun part. I'm going to explain to you the power of this particular piece of software, not just to show you what you can do when you're building your own lesson plans, but also to show you what your students might be doing. It'll all make sense in a moment. So check this out. We have several tabs all up here at the top, standard things that you're used to seeing before. Oh yeah, you also in this area have the option to draw things. So if you wanted to make a picture, for example, of an apple, all you have to do is take out the scribble tool and you can create some beautiful artistic. See how it smooths out the lines for you? Nice, right? Now this is great when you're taking notes, particularly about apples. Let's make sure that I put the shine there. So you can see this is a crispy apple. All right, there you go. So it's really easy to access the different functions. And of course, you can erase all this. But you know what? I'm going to leave this here just so you guys can remember what on earth we did. So here you can say that the teacher was talking about apples, or when they draw a diagram on the board, you can draw it out. I find myself using that quite often. The tab that we're interested in today is this button, not tab, this button right here, which is the audio notes toolbar. When I click on that, you will notice a toolbar that pops up that looks like this. So over here, you'll notice the input levels over here. Input volume, so you can adjust how much audio you're going to be capturing in terms of, let's say you're a really loud person, you'd want to turn down the input so that it doesn't turn red where you can see the input over there. So leave that in the middle there and you have your input volume. And over here we have our play controls, so record and playback once we've actually started recording. And on the far right over here we have the audio file size. You're going to want to pay special attention to this, particularly if you have a small hard drive. But anyways, when you get into recording audio, the file size is marginally bigger nowadays than the original text file would be. But Microsoft Word 2008 has a great compression set in it that keeps the file size down. Okay, so for example, let's type out some notes while sound is being recorded. So what we're going to do is click on the record button here to start recording, and let's say the note is "The professor is explaining a story about spelling the word desserts backwards." I'm doing this because I'm pretending that the professor is explaining a story about spelling the word desserts. All right, so now let's move up here to stop and click stop. And if you notice, when I highlight over here, I highlighted the bullet point and it stays next to the file. But if you notice over here, when I highlight, there's a little audio icon here. What does that mean? That means when I click around this area, I'm able to, the note listen is to that sound.
The professor is explaining a story about spelling.
You should be able to hear what you recorded while you were typing the notes.
Backwards.
You can also see over here how long the file itself was. Or sorry, the recording
I'm doing this because
was.
I'm pretending that the professor is explaining a story about spelling the word dessert.
So, what does that mean? Let's think about what this actually means. It means one of two things. We've captured something, what was said, and we made a note of it. You know, sometimes it's almost impossible to keep up when somebody's talking and you're taking notes. Well, this might make things a little bit easier for you. So, remember, it is illegal to record somebody without his or her prior consent and knowledge. So don't use this technique unless you obtain permission. Just like most of your students who have laptops with embedded microphone in their laptops will, right?